Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be going over case assignment roles in Salesforce. But before I get into the video, I would love for you to hit the like button and the subscribe button. I'm about 14 subscribers away from hitting 1,000 as we're recording this video, and it would really mean a lot to me if you would do that and join the family here. Now let's jump back into case assignment roles. So case assignment roles are pretty much the same thing as lead assignment roles, just rebranded and revolving around the case object and the case's fields. So let's jump into the setup and go to case assignment roles. All right, so you have your rule and then your rule entries. I'm gonna go new for new rule. I have this be a new one. I am going to click activate because this is a test org. You would not want to do this in production unless you knew that this is a brand new org. You can do all the testing you want and no cases are going to be coming in and you won't have any be missed. So I'm going to click save. I'm going to go into the new rule, click new rule entry. I have it be the first sort order. And typically what I've seen case assignment roles used for is for routing it within an IT org or an IT department. So let's say you have multiple aspects of the IT department and you have cases that are relating to Salesforce, and then maybe you have cases relating to a certain fintech tool, and then maybe to a project management tool, and again to a time management tool. So what you could do is you could have it be based to route to the different people based upon what the subject contains. And you can say, hey users, please put the name of the tool within the subject of your case. But for this scenario, that's what we're going to do. I want the subject, if it contains the word Salesforce, to be routed to myself. You can also have this be routed to a queue. But because we do not have this in this org yet, and I am the sole admin, I am going to click save. And there you go. We have a case assignment rule. If a case with a subject containing Salesforce comes in, it'll be routed automatically to myself. You can do the same thing. So let's say this subject does not contain Salesforce, then you can have another rule, and let's have it be, let's find the subject contains time. So if this is the time management tool, have it be assigned to John Smith. Now this might throw an error because you might not have the right permissions. That's right, so I'm gonna have it be assigned to myself just for the purposes of this. But then you can assign it to the time management person. So this is based upon a true false type of statement. So if it is true, then it'll assign it to myself. If it is false, it'll go to the next criteria or the next rule entry, and so on and so forth. So there you go. Those are case assignment rules. Be sure to like and subscribe. Really helps out my channel and helps me create more helpful videos like this. And I will catch you guys in the next one.